You don't care who you sell the drugs to, do you?
No, I, you know, not that I don't, but like I'm just trying to like make sure that, you know, I get my product moving.
It should be fun, sharing silly videos or lovely photos, lovely and positive and part of their social world. And then you throw into that drugs, and how do they make sense of managing? This is something that's great and this is something that isn't.
Polling data that we commissioned showed that actually 1 in 4 young people are now seeing drugs advertised for sale on social media.
This is my daughter, Jodie Buick. She was funny, sassy, a bit of a diva, a bit of a drama queen, loved to sing. We got told by the girl that stayed with her that they got the drugs from someone from Snapchat.
I want to find out just how easy it is to find drugs in this way on social media. So I've set up a Snapchat account, I've set up an Instagram account, and I'm going to search for a few phrases and see what comes up.
What's good, man?
So you do this all the time on Snapchat? It's not, I'm not like the first person you've ever done this to or anything.
No. I got loads of people.
Because I should point out, I'm actually a BBC journalist, and I just want to ask you, you've made no checks as to who I am, and you're willing to sell potentially very dangerous drugs through the post. I could be anyone.
Do you have a problem with that?
Well, do you have a problem? You're selling potentially deadly drugs. I could end up dead from the product you're selling.
I assume that you are a user already. You already know your way around it.
You've invited us along today because you've got a video that you want to show us that sort of shows how this area of marketing is basically changing a bit. Do you want to show us?
Sure.
Looking pretty slick, isn't it? They're not only advertising drugs for sale in the area, but they're saying, come and work for me as a dealer.
Absolutely, and videos such as these give dealing a level of credibility that we haven't seen before. It's legitimising it, it's making it look like a glamorous occupation, and our concern is it could be getting more people, particularly young people, into the drugs trade.
I feel very frustrated by seeing it all over my social media because it's glamorized being a drug dealer, taking drugs. It's all become the norm now. It's everywhere on social media.
Anyone who's tried to send a pirated film or like TV show a link, if you've tried to send a link to one of those through Facebook Messenger, you'll get a message saying cannot be sent. They know what you're talking about, and they do stop people from talking about things they don't want you to, so they have the tools that they need.
There's two parts to this. Firstly, we recognise we've got a responsibility to go after those that's committing the crime, we get that, but we also recognise that the media services have got a duty to prevent some of this in the first place. If that was a son or daughter of one of the social networks that are providing or allowing this to take place, would they be thinking we should be doing more about it? I'm certainly would.
Obviously, whatever mechanism they're using to block particular words and hashtags isn't effective because they're still there.